Hi students, today we are going to revise chapter 1 and chapter 2, right? And for your quarterly exam, what are the portions you are having means totally 6 chapters, right? Totally 6 chapters. Chapter number 1, number system. Chapter number 2, polynomials. And chapter number 4, linear equation in two variables. And chapter number 12, right? Heron's formula. And chapter number 14, statistics. And chapter number 15, probably 36 chapters. So before revising all the chapters, right? Before revising all the chapters, you want to know the question pattern, right? You want to know the question pattern. So totally 21 marks. How many 1 marks? 21 marks, right? 21 marks is equal to 20, right? And 6 2 marks, 12 marks, 8 3 marks. Right, the question pattern is nothing but 21 marks, 6 2 marks and 8 3 marks. 8 3s are 24 and 6 4 marks. Right, 6 4s are 24. Totally 80 marks. And this is nothing but 10th public pattern. And this pattern is nothing but 10th public exam question pattern. Max, for max, how it will be means 21 marks, 6 2 mark, 8 3 mark and 6 4 marks. Right, we are having 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 mark and 4 mark. Right. In 21 marks, right, in 21 marks, it has been divided, right, it has been divided into three kinds. The first one is nothing but 10 1 marks is nothing but, right, 10 1 marks, that is nothing but choose the best, choose the correct answer, right. 10 1 marks is nothing but choose the correct answer. And 5 1 mark is nothing but fill ups. 5 1 marks is nothing but fill ups. And the remaining 5 1 marks is nothing but write in short answers, right? By getting a very small simplification, we'll get a solution, right? So small short answers, right? Very small, very short answer, very short answers. So we have to solve and we have to find the solutions, right? And this is the question pattern. 21 marks, and 21 marks, 10 choose, 5 fill ups and 5 short answers, very short answers, and 6 2 marks, 8 3 marks and 6 4 marks, right? See, actually how you want to prepare, right, how you want to prepare for your exams means, see, not only for this 9th standard, right, you are going to, next year you are going to face a public exam, right? So how you want to prepare means, right, first you have to complete all the classwork sums. The classwork sums is nothing but maximum we have completed only on NCERT problems, right? So first you have to complete the NCERT problems, right? First you have to complete NCERT problem, right? Exercise sums, exercise and the example sums. So we have to first complete the NCERT problems. Then we have to come to that. I have every week Saturday I am just posting a worksheets, right? So next you have to concentrate on, right? Next you have to concentrate on worksheets, right? Next you have to concentrate on worksheets. And the next one is nothing but week test, unit test. Weekly we are conducting unit test. No, that unit test also you have to see, right? First you have to complete the NCERT. Next you have to complete the worksheet. And next you have to revise the UTs at UT questions, right? Unit test question answers, right? This is the methodology we have to prepare for our exams, right? This is the methodology. And I think so you have completed all the classworks, right, in classwork note. And you are maintaining some separate worksheet, right? And if you are having a guide, right, you just go through the guide also. It's not a problem, right? Only for seeing the extra sums, right? Why we are following the guide? Only for seeing or solving the extra sums, right? And this is the methodology, right? So okay, now the revision is nothing but I won't give you that this is the important sum, this is the important concept. I never teach you like that methodology, right? I will teach you all the concepts. Each and every concepts are important, right? Each and every concepts are important, and you have to focus all the concept that is very important, right? You have to focus all the concept that is important. See, revision is nothing but I will always, what are things we have discussed in this first chapter, right? For the first chapter, right? For this chapter, what are things we are needed, and how, what are the methods, and what are the concepts we are having, right? What are the formulas we have discussed? This is the only. This is the way of revision, right? This is the only way of revision, right? Okay, in this first chapter, we are having six exercises, right? In this first chapter, we are having six exercises. So before we enter into the concept, right, you have to revise all definitions. First, you have to revise all the definitions, right? So to thorough first definitions, right? What is mean by natural number? What is mean by whole number? What is mean by integers, right? What is mean by rational number? What is mean by irrational number? First, to thorough the definitions, right? Okay, in the exercise 1.1, what we are discussing means, right? We have to find that whether the given number is a rational number or not, right? Whether the given number is a rational number or not. Otherwise, we want to find some rational numbers between the rational numbers, right? So, rational number, what is the definition of rational number? A number which is in the form of P by Q, right? A number which is in the form of P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0 and P and Q are integers, right? P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0, then the number is called a rational number. Then the given number is called as a rational number, right? So we want to find some rational numbers between some rational number. See, I'm just asking that whether 3 is a rational number. Yeah, 3 is nothing but we can write in the form of P by Q. 3 by 1 is nothing but 3, right? 3 by 1 is nothing but 3. So it is also P by Q form, right? P by Q form. So if you are whatever we are writing the number, it is the form of P by Q, then it is a rational number. So 3 is a rational number, right? 3 is a rational number. Suppose I am just taking the 5, 3 and 5. Find rational numbers between these two rational numbers. How we want to find rational numbers between these two rational numbers? I am just putting 5 by 1, 3 by 1, right? So I am just making as a rational numbers. How we are going to find the rational numbers between these rational numbers? Simple, very simple. Just multiplying by 10 on all the both numerators and denominators, right? Then it will become, what is it? 30 divided by 10 and 50 divided by 10, right? 30 divided by 10, 50 divided by 10. In between, what are the numbers we are having? 31 divided by 10, 32 divided by 10, 33 divided by 10, up to 49 divided by 10. We are having so many rational numbers between. And before that, I want to discuss that how many rational numbers between two rational numbers. How many rational numbers between two rational numbers? There are infinite. That is very, very important, right? Here we are having only, what is that? 19 numbers alone there. Only we are having 19 numbers. See, I am just multiplying by 10. That's why I am getting 19, right? Suppose I am multiplying by 100, in between, multiplying by 100, then we will get more numbers, right? Just I am multiplying by 1000, multiplying by 10,000, we will get so many numbers. So, just keep this thing in your mind. For two rational numbers, right, there are infinite number of rational numbers between two rational numbers, right? Right? In this first concept, right, we are discussing that finding the rational numbers between two rational numbers, finding the rational numbers between two rational numbers, right? And second exercise is nothing but fully definitions, right? So what is the natural numbers? A number starts from 1 to infinity, that is called as a natural numbers, right? When we are including a 0 with a natural number, when we are including the 0 with a natural number, then it will become, what is it? Whole number, right? Then it will become a whole numbers. When we are including the negative numbers, right? Negative numbers with the whole number, then it will become integers, right? When we included the negative numbers with the whole number, then it will be integers. All the integers, right? All the integers are always called as here rational numbers. All the integers are called as here rational numbers. And irrational number, that is separate, right? Irrational numbers is a separate noun. And a combination of rational and irrational is always called as a real numbers, right? Real numbers. So based on this, we are having some definitions, right? And moreover, in this exercise, we are having that showing that the root values, irrational values in the number line, that you don't want to prepare for that this exam, right? The third exercise 1.3, right? 1.3 is nothing but decimal expansion, right? Decimal expansion, right? I told you that already a real number has been divided into two types. One is nothing but rational number, another one is nothing but irrational number, right? Decimal expansion for rational number. Decimal expansion for the rational number is nothing but, right? Decimal expansion for the rational number is nothing but it will divide into two types. We are having two types. One is nothing but terminating decimal expansion, right? Decimal expansion. Another one is something but non-terminating and repeating, right? Non-terminating and repeating decimal expansion. Non-terminating and repeating decimal expansion. Suppose if it is a non-terminating and non-repeating, right? Non-repeating decimal expansion, then it will be a irrational number. Right? And square root values, right? Square root of 2, square root of 3, cube root of 5, right? Cube root of 5, cube root of 7, right? And these numbers also comes under the irrational. Pi value is also irrational, right? Pi is also example for an irrational number, right? Pi is also example for an irrational number. So next is 1.3. We are having that write the following in decimal form and say what kind of decimal expansion, right? Writing the rational number in the decimal form and say that what kind of decimal form, right? And next, still we are having some more sum. The reason is by writing the form of p by q form, right? They will give in the form of non-terminating and repeating format, right? 0.36 bar, right? 0.36 bar, like they are giving means, then how we want to find, we will assume that what is that x is equal to 0.36 bar, right? So here only one digit, the bar is belongs to only one digit, so we want to multiply by 10 on both sides, then it will become, what is it, 10x is equal to, see how we will write, we have to expand, so x is equal to 0.3666, so one digit alone came to the left side, so it will become, what is it, 3.6666, likewise, right? And this is the equation number 1 and this is equation number 2, and by subtracting these two equations we will get what, we will get the value of x. And we will write in the form of p by q, right? X is nothing but, what is it, 0.36 bar, then we will write in the form of p by q, right? And classify that the given numbers are rational or irrational, right? Classify the numbers are rational or irrational, right? See that root 12 is a irrational, right? Root 12 is a irrational because 12 won't came out from the root, because see, do the prime factorization 12, right? 2 table 6 times, 2 table 3 times, 3 table 1 times. So square root of 2 into 2 into 3, right? Square root of 2 into 2 into 3. So 2, so it will came out from the root. So 2 into square root of 3, right? 2 into square root of 3. See, that still 12 is equal to 2 root 3, right? Still we are having root value. So root 12 is a irrational number. Root 12 is a irrational number. Suppose I am taking that root 16, right? Root 16, just do the prime factorization. Doing the prime factorization, 2 table, then 8 times, 2 table, 4 times, 2 table, 2 times, 2 table, 1 times. So see that square root of 16 is equal to, for this pair we will get 1, 2. For this pair we will get 1, 2, right? 2. So 2 into 2 is equal to 4, right? Is there any root values are there? Square root of 16 is equal to 4. Is there any root values are there? Nothing is there. So square root of 16 is nothing but a rational number. So classifying the rational numbers, okay? Not only we are having that by seeing the root value alone, we are not deciding that whether it is a rational or irrational. We are having that in the form of decimal form also. By seeing the decimal form also, we have to classify whether it is a rational or irrational number. Next exercise 1.5. Next one is an image, exercise 1.5, and this exercise and next exercise only very, very important, right? We can expect one or two sums from 3 marks or 4 marks, right, from this exercise. And this exercise we are going to classify the following number as rational or irrational, right? So while we are solving, right, finally we want to see that, and finally we want to see that whether it is a rational or irrational, right? So it will be in the form of a plus b the whole square, or what is it, a minus b the whole square, or a square minus b square, identity, by using this identity, right? So if it is in the form of a plus b the whole square or a minus b whole square, it should be a irrational number. Suppose in the form of a square minus b square, then it won't be a irrational, it is in the form of rational, right? And moreover, in this exercise, rationalize the denominator. Very, very important concept is nothing but rationalize the denominator, right? Rationalize the denominator. How we want to do the rationalize the denominator? Simple. 2 root divided by 3 plus root 5, right? 2 divided by 3 plus root 5. See the denominator, how it will be? Rational plus irrational is equal to irrational. So in the denominator is irrational. So what we want to do? We want to convert the denominator in the form of rational, right? Convert this denominator in the form of rational. So what we want to do that? It is a form of a plus b. So we want to multiply by a minus b into a minus b, right? So it is nothing but 3. We want to multiply by both numerator and denominator by 3 minus root 5, right? So a by 3 plus root 5 into 3 minus root 5 divided by 3 minus root 5, right? A by 3 plus root 5 into 3 minus root 5, 3 minus root 5. Just multiply, sorry, not A, it's 2, right? Just multiply the denominator, how it will be? A plus B into A minus B. A plus B into A minus B is nothing but A square minus B square. So 3 square minus root 5 the whole square, right? 3 square minus root 5 the whole square. 3 square is nothing but 9. Square will get cancelled. 9 minus 5 is equal to 4, right? Denominator, how it will be? It is in the form of rational. So we have to see that only we have to convert only the denominator as a rational, right? Rationalizing the denominator, rationalizing the denominator, and in this concept, in this exercise, and this kind of sums are very very important. And the next concept is nothing but loss of exponents, right? Loss of exponents. How many loss we are having? Totally 8 loss. Loss of exponents, right? Loss of exponent. How many loss we are having? 8 loss, right? So it's nothing but a power m into b power. So a power m into a power n. 1 by 1 will go. Sorry, right? A power m into a power n is nothing but base are same and power. We want to multiply. Is add a power m plus n, right? And next one is nothing but a power m divided by a power n, right? Base are same and if we are dividing, then we want to subtract the powers, right? A power m minus n, right? And third one is nothing but power to the power, right? A power m the whole power n is equal to power to the power, means we want to multiply the powers. A power m into n. A power m into n. Next last nothing but same exponent, right? Same exponent and different base. So a power m into b power m can be written as a into b whole power m, right? Writing the power only once as a common one, right? And the a power m divided by b power m is nothing but a divided by b, right? A divided by b or a by b whole power m, right? And anything power 0, right? Anything power 0, it is equal to 1. A power 0 is equal to 1. And the last exponent is nothing but, what is the last one? It is nothing but square root of a power m divided by n is equal to square root of n into a power m, right? A power m square root of n, right? So first we have to thorough this loss, and we are having some property to follow, right? What are the properties we are having to follow? It's nothing but first we have to see that the base, right? The base value should be a prime numbers. If it is not in the form of prime number, first what we want to do? Convert to the prime numbers by doing prime factorization. After doing the prime factorization, then we want to see that which law is applicable. We have to apply the loss of exponents and we have to simplify, right? And today first chapter is enough, right? Tomorrow we will see the second chapter, right? Second chapter and fourth chapter. Thank you.